Now then, here we are in the beautiful Lake District. I've just set off from Haweswater, which just set behind me here, and I am heading up into the beautiful mountains up this way. Now today is hot, it is one of those days, just got to be really careful. I've got plenty of sunscreen on and I've also got a hat and everything else that you sort of need to think about when it comes to being exposed to the sunshine. But yeah, we need to head up into the mountains and find somewhere nice and cool that we can sort of chill out. Now the good thing about being here is we've got small water on the left hand side here, and on the right hand side there is Blee Tarn, and both are really nice places to chill out and have a dip, so I think that is what the plan will be. Anyway, we need to get up there, find a place to pitch a tent, drink a nice beer and just enjoy the beautiful Lake District. It is just a cracking day, absolutely cracking. Let's get on. What a fantastic day. It is just a pleasure to be alive. Look at that, it's just incredible. Sunshine, sweating like a pig out on a mountain. It truly does put happiness through your veins, and I advise it to anyone. And we've just got this sort of water cascading down there, and it's just lovely to hear that as well. So yeah, massaging all my senses. So today I've got some new kit to show you. I've had some new kit given by Mammut, and one being a sleeping bag, which might be a bit of overkill for today because I think it's only going to drop down tonight to about 14 degrees, whereas this down sleeping bag will probably go down to about zero, I think. I can't remember the stats on it, but it's got a central zip, which is actually brilliant for when it is hot, because you can open it up and just be free to the underside of your tent. So great way of cooling off, perfect for in a hammock as well. I'm pretty sure it's going to be my go-to hammock sleeping system, using this Mammut sleeping bag. And I've also got a jacket and a pair of trousers there as well. A jacket and a pair of trousers there as well, which I'm going to get out when we get up there as it starts to cool off. But yeah, what a day. Well, here we are at Small Water, and it's just incredible. I mean, it just sits in this massive ball all the way around, and you can just see sort of how high up it goes around there. But yeah, an epic place to come. There's a few places to pitch a tent actually, which is pretty good, but I just sort of feel that I'm gonna carry on a little bit further. But hot day, it's begging me to get in there, isn't it? It is begging me. So yes, let's clamber down to the water's edge, have a quick dip before we ascend to higher places. well, that was about as peaceful and calm as you can get, just laying back in the water and just looking up at the sky. Just incredible. And what a place to do it. Look at this. Got a few people over here just having a quick dip as well. But it's a perfect day for it. It really is, just to cool your body down again. Oh, yeah, breathing life in. That's what it is. Just amazing. What a place to eat a peach. Can't beat it. Well, that was just a lovely place to stop off and just chill out for a while. Anyway, we're going to move on and head up onto the top of the mountain somewhere and find a place to pitch a tent. I'm quite tempted just to stay here really, because it is just an incredible place, but let's explore a bit further. Yeah, I tell you what, just getting in something like that, cooling your body down, just does make a massive difference. And now I'm climbing up this sort of steep section now, and yeah, just feel quite refreshed, like I'm on fresh legs again. Stunning place though, just really is. And I'm sort of been having a look around, and if you can sort of see up there, there's a couple of areas that potentially I could pitch a tent. Just some sort of little nibs that sort of stick out with a bit of a flat section of grass on top. But you don't know until you get there, so I'm gonna work my way up here, probably come round the top, drop back down, and then we'll have a look and sort of see. Who knows? This is the best thing about it. I'm also quite aware that I've been out in the sun for quite a while now. So although I've got decent sunscreen on, you just can't rely on that for being exposed all day. So what I've got with me is, it's like a long sleeve surfer's top really. And I've sort of used it for bodyboarding, but if you put that on, it's actually got a factor 50 rating with it anyway, and it comes up hood over the top and pretty much covers your whole upper body. So that might be coming on soon. Well, I've just ditched the bag a minute because just over here, I've just noticed a couple of places that potentially we could just pitch a tent, and it looks awesome. And you don't know unless you walk over and have a look. So this is why it's nice to come and explore rather than doing all the sort of normal places that most people go to, because it might be just that extra special place that just is fantastic. Well, look at that view. This is actually quite an incredible pitch. The only problem is there's a bit of sphagnum moss in here, and that means water. So if I just show you here, it's a little bit spongy and damp. I could probably get away with it today because it's so dry, but I mean, it's so flat as well. Really flat is that. Yeah. Anyway, worth having a look at. I will log this for a future date for myself. But I mean, the view there, it's about as good as you get, really. Well, you can hear that trickling water. And this might be the last place that I can get some decent water, so look at that. Perfect way to fill my bottles up. Probably wouldn't even really need to filter it there, to be fair, because it's filtered through the ground, but I will filter it anyway. So there we go, I've got some water filtered and I've got this ready to filter. Might as well just fill up everything possible, because you just do not know whether there's going to be a water source further up or not. So let's move on. Well, we're just coming to the sort of highest point, the col we'll call it. And then it's just great because you can see down the other side, but just look at this view here. Look over here. Just just spectacular. Wow. Not a cloud in the sky. And you can just see up there, we've got an aeroplane just spoiling it. And that's it. That is it. Well, I haven't really been filming much. I've been sort of taking it all in, chatting to people, just sort of relaxing back. But it's getting on a bit. It's 5 o'clock now. And it'd be nice just to find somewhere to pitch a tent, really. So let's get to the summit. And then from there, I'm going to come back down and just hopefully just find like the most picturesque place to pitch a tent. So just walking off the summit of Ilbel. And then this is the first time that you can actually see Bleawater. It almost doesn't look real down there. And you can see the shadow being cast here, all the way down there. But it's such a big craggy outcrop, all that. Just beautiful. So from here, I'm gonna head down onto this section somewhere and hopefully find somewhere just to slip this tent in with a view. Pretty much the first bit of shade I found all day. Oh, that is nice. Sit here a minute. Hey Bluey. Good lad. Not a bad view though. Let's flip you around. Look at this. I've rested in worse places. Just back overlooking small water. Oh, look at that. A pair of Ray-Bans. That's a bit random. Anyway, leave no trace. Pick it up and carry it. But I'm just hoping I can find somewhere just along here, just to pitch a tent somewhere. I've had enough of sun now. I'm not bothered about getting a sunset. I just want a nice morning view. And something like that is just off the scale, isn't it? Amazing. This is it then. That is not a bad view at all, is it? Looking down the valley to Hawswater where I set off from, and then just turning around here, we've got small water where I was having a dip earlier. Onto this one, which is Harter Fell. And I mean, look at all the shadows being cast there. It just looks beautiful already. And if I flip you around this way, we can still see a little bit of Bleawater. And if you look right in the distance, the highest point up there, that is Kidsty Pike. And I've camped up there, and that is a brilliant pitch. I've got to say, it was a really nice pitch up there. Ah, yes, again, living the dream, just for those few days here and there. Anyway, let's get this tent pitched and crack open a beer. There we go, that is the tent pitched, and it is the Terra Nova Starlight 1. I really do like it. Every time I pitch it, I just think it looks awesome. So yeah, very happy with that. And I mean, just the view out there is just fantastic. It really is. So yeah, I'm looking forward to the morning and just sitting out and taking in the sunrise. Currently the sun, you can just sort of see the sun line there. It's just about gonna put the tent in the shade, which I cannot wait for because I've had too much sunshine today. But I'm gonna show you the sleeping bag that I've been given by Mammut. So this is from their recovery series, and I think all that is, it's just a bit more of a relaxed shape bag. Rather than having your sort of mummy fit, which you just sort of feel like full claustrophobic in, it's just a little bit wider, and a little bit wider at the bottom as well. Anyway, it comes with this stuff sack, which compresses quite small actually. And if I just open this out, nice bright colour, and I'll show you that as well, because the midges are starting to bite. The outside colour of this is just quite a nice sort of like, I want to call it cloud white. It's just a slight grey really. And the bag itself has a central zip, so it just sort of sits straight over you, which I really like, because come summer like this, if you're hot, you just open it up and you just can keep yourself a little bit cooler. Inside the hood, they've used a material which is a bit different to the rest of it. And instead of like being laid on a crisp packet, they've used like a softer material, just so it's a bit more comfortable and obviously not doesn't make as much noise near your ears. If I open it up, this is when you're going to get the shock factor. But look at that. What a colour. As bright as you can get is that. But if you ever need to signal someone on a mountain, this is going to be the way for it. Or if you ever need to land a jet or a Boeing 747 or whatever. But yeah, really nice sleeping bag. I'm quite impressed by it. Oh, midges are biting. I need to go get covered up. Anyway, it is a 0 degree bag and it's got a comfort limit of 5 degrees. So it pretty much do 3 seasons in the UK, not a problem whatsoever, and pretty much all winter as well, really. It's got an internal pocket there just for bobbing your phone in, and simple drawstring at the top. It doesn't have like a neck baffle, which some of them do, but I think it's quite good this, because it's just simple, it's wider, and it's just more of a comfort fit, I'd say. So yeah, I'm looking forward to sleeping in it. Well, I think I'm set up, changed my top, put some long bottoms on, and just sat taking in this view, but it's not bad. Look at this. That is not bad at all. I can cope with that. What a view. I've been saying it all day, but it is just spectacular, that. Anyway, I'm covered up now. I've got my long sleeve top on, and this is my Factor 50 top, which I should have had on earlier in the day, I would have thought. If it's sunny tomorrow, this is definitely going on. But I've also got on these Mammut bottoms, which as soon as I put these on, it was like putting on a pair of pajamas. They are just so comfortable. The material itself is just really, really soft, and it's got like a high abrasion material just sort of on the knees and the butt area and down to the floor where you might be sort of catching your legs. Anywhere that's going to be touching rocks, really, because they are based on a climbing pant, so you can actually put a harness on with these. But yeah, just pockets, you know, usual sort of game. There's one on the back as well. But the main thing for me is they just fit perfectly. They're my absolute dream fit. So yeah, very happy with these. So I'll do my modelling. For me, I think they're going to be well used, purely because they are so stretchy that I think I'll be able to move fast and even run in these. They do have a DWR coating on as well, which just sort of repels a bit of water. And the bottoms of these are quite good because you can sort of clip the ankle a little bit tighter, so it'll clip onto your boot, but also it'll just tighten up around my ankle so I can have my fell running shoes on and still run no problem without it sort of like dragging or getting in the way. Also the top, it's got a sort of a Velcro belt system here, so you don't actually have to have a proper belt, which is great because if you're carrying a backpack, you don't have that sort of backpack that's bouncing and smacking against your belt, and it sometimes can really irritate me, so I am very happy with that. Anyway, it is time to make some food and possibly crack open a beer. Well, first job, I'm going to feed the dog because he didn't actually eat that much this morning. So I'll just get his food out. Just got a wet pouch and some dry food as well. But I've got, look at this, way of feeding him. I'm going to try out this. It's a tiny little foldaway bowl. Fits in your hand. So I just unclip that. And it's just enough to hold water because it is seam sealed. And obviously put his food in as well. So we'll just give him a go with this and see what he thinks. Can't get it out of the packet though. There we go. But I mean, the size and weight of it is literally nothing. It's like a little chef's hat. So yeah, just enough just to put some bits in for him, and obviously it will hold water, so not a bad little bowl that for lightweight sort of backpacking if you're taking your dog with you. Anyway, let's give him some food. You excited, Blue? He's just sat here watching me. You excited? You want some food? Oh dear. Anyway, let's get this dog food into this bowl. Give that a squidge around in there for him. Well, typical collie, you put it in a bowl for him and he didn't want to eat it, so I'll just tip some out on the floor and he's eating the stuff off the floor. Do some more. Here then. Well, obviously, it's definitely a water bowl only, so I'll have to think again for his feeding, but generally he'll eat off the floor anyway, so I'm not too worried about that. Or just off a rock or something. There you go. I'm just contemplating whether I should take this net off to eat my dinner, because currently these midges are horrendous, and even with this net on, some are still getting inside and I'm having to still squash them. Horrible things. So yeah, I might need to buy a better net than this one. I mean, I can see a couple just in here now. Anyway, for dinner I have one of these tuna salads. And they're actually quite nice, these, and because they're ready to sort of eat, you don't have to mess about when you're on a mountain cooking. I do have stuff to cook as well, but I'm going to have that and a couple of scotch eggs. So that should definitely fill me up and keep me happy for the evening. And then as soon as I've had that and these midges dissipate a little bit, then I will be cracking open a beer and just taking in the last bit of a... the sunshine. Fantastic night though, fantastic. Well, I decided the only way to eat my dinner and actually enjoy it without just crying every 2 seconds and having to run away was to sit inside the tent. And it's not the biggest tent, but look at the view. I've still got a window. So that ain't too bad, is it? I can still see out of that. Anyway, dinner time.
Told you what to chase, told you how to run the race, every move was on the page, but I didn't like their way, had to fight and misbehave, had to find a way to change, had to leave to find my way. Caught up in a daydream, I beat my mind up there almost daily. It's how I pass time, no opinions safely. It's how I understand what I want in this place. See, cause everybody wanna tell you bad things, what could go wrong, what fame brings, but success. Success is a finicky thing, and if you ain't sure, no, it'll never be.
Right, I'm gonna see if I dare take this midge net off, because they have been horrendous. I don't even know why they're on earth. What is the point of midges? I mean, all they do is ruin your evening. You know, all you want to do is chill out, you know, take in the view and drink a nice beer and just enjoy it, and they ruin it for you, don't they, Blue? Hey, right, get off then. Sturdy pad there, it's not bursting with his claws. Anyway, we have a beer here to drink, which was kindly donated by Jesus, midges. Whoa, there are millions. Come on, wind, take them away. Oh my god, just let's do one of them dances to get rid of it. God, that is relentless. Give up, leave me alone. It's like, oh my god, this is going back on again. Just, we'll come back to the beer in a minute. Oh, Jesus, Blue, that was terrible. Right, take two quickly. I think they've gone. Nope, I just can't see them because I've got this on. Oh my god, just leave me alone. Why ruin life? Come on, there's no point. Just go back to hell, please. Oh dear me, Blue, hey. There's not much that frustrates me in life, but midges are just the worst. Enjoyment of a mountain beer, take three. Let's do this. Come on. Please, just all turn into nice butterflies. So this beer was provided to me by a guy called Gary, who is one of my Patreon. And we met up one night just randomly because we were sort of in the same area. And we sat and had a few beers together, him and his partner. And it was just an absolutely awesome night. I really, really enjoyed it. And he gave me this as a leaving present, also another beer as well. So I'll try this one first, and then if I feel like it, I'll have another one as well. But it might be midge dependent. Anyway, this one is from Vocation Breweries, and it is an Imperial, oh, it's called the Imperial Banana Chocolate and Banana Stout. I'm expecting this to be like a milkshake. And it's 11.4%. So yes, this is pudding and a few shots all mixed together. Anyway, let's get it open and see what it tastes like. Yep, that is like mashed bananas with whiskey in it. That's what it smells like. Yeah, completely that. It's not too bad, actually. That is not bad. It is, it's definitely like a pudding, you know, like if you had sort of like chocolate liqueurs or something like that. That's what it tastes like. It really does. Yep, not bad. 11.4% as well, so that is gonna probably make me fall or roll down this mountain. Anyway, I'm gonna hopefully sit back and just take this last little bit of sunshine, which is just catching the mountaintops around here. Yeah. Almost living the dream. Take away the midges. Here, look around here. Just look how the sun's just catching the top of there. Yeah, it's pretty awesome really, isn't it? I can't complain. Seriously, just leave me. Midges. Seriously. What a day. Yeah, it's nice to get to the end of the day knowing that you've done a lot in it. And I just feel that I've had a lot of me time today, just where I've just chilled out and just really taken it all in and just, you know, sat back and just breathed properly rather than just rushing through everything. Yeah. And then it's just nice now just to get to the end of the evening and just sip a cup of tea slowly just before I get ready for bed. Yeah, just taking it all in really. The first half of that beer went down pretty well and then it hit me. The weight of it is just like a chewy one, it really is. So the second half I was just really slowly sipping. So anyway, it was nice to chill out, and although the midges were relentless, it was just nice sort of taking in all these views, because you know, this is a 10 out of 10 for views. Even though the pitch, I'll only give about a 2 out of 10 because it's not great. It really isn't. Not much space, a little bit rocky, hard to get pegs in. And, you know, you've got to sort of try these places. And pretty much, I don't think anyone will have pitched a tent here before. So it's nice to sort of be the first one out here. Compared to down behind me, where there is probably about, I think I counted 16 tents, but that was a while ago. So there might even be some more. Anyway, it is time to rest these old bones, and I look forward to getting in that lovely Mammut sleeping bag and just testing that out. So, we'll see thee in the morning. Morning flowers. Well, it was quite a chilly night. I sort of slept through till just before 5 o'clock, and then I sort of got up and started watching the sunrise. And then the midges were out, so I decided to get back in the tent, but then an hour later it got really hot with the sun on the tent. So I unzipped the sleeping bag fully and just laid on top of the mat. And then I've slept through till about 7:30. But yeah, and like, if you look here, we've got a cloud inversion and it's rolling towards us. It's almost like a tide coming in, because at 5 o'clock this morning it was way out and it's just on its way back now. Yeah, so we need to stay high up and out of the clouds. Fantastic morning though. I mean, just all these sort of shadows being sort of cast all around and about. And then on this side as well, you can just see these lines of shadows just dropping down into the blee water there. And I've been listening to some guy just shouting, "Dido, Dido!" His dog's run off, and I don't know, I haven't seen any sheep moving or anything like that, but he's trying to get his dog back. So yeah, that tractive dog tracker would be a good shout, definitely. Yeah, it's nice to be out though, isn't it? Every time, I just love it. Dog. Yep, back out the midges. Well annoying. Anyway, you can see the cloud rolling in towards us. It's really nice to sort of watch it come in. And the level of it is still pretty low. If you look sort of over there, you can still see Kidsty Pike just sort of poking its head out. And it just sort of means for us today that we need to stay high just so we can sort of still see something rather than just being clagged in. Yeah, it's coming in pretty quick. I've not even had breakfast yet because I've had this head net on, and the midges honestly just ruin it. They really do ruin it. So anyway, I'm going to get breakfast, get this tent packed away, and then yeah, get ourselves off onto the next one, I reckon. we go then, all packed up, ready for the next adventure. There's a bit of a breeze coming through now, so it has pushed away all those midges, but they've only gone back down to the depths of hell. They will be back another day to annoy somebody else, maybe one of you guys. Anyway, if you have liked the video, give it one of those and share the video, share my channel. You know, it's just about positivity, and if you feel that someone's going to benefit from that, then just let them know, get them to join in, and you know, join this is what it's all about, getting out and just enjoying life. So yes, and if you'd like to contribute to the channel, there is a buy me a coffee link, and you can also join the Patreon. And I'm on Instagram as well, so if you want to follow me on there, and I generally sort of have a bit more interaction with people on there. So anyway, leave no trace as always. Always double check around and about. Make sure you haven't left any corners of any packets, any tent pegs, because that's a common one. But it is time to get off. Are you ready, Blue? Yeah? Come on then, let's skedaddle.